Hi everybody, it's me Jen, and I am here to do something I haven't done in a long time. I got some of my scents. I've been trying to find a male scent for Matthew. He complains that his soap that I make for him isn't scented and colored. And I do this because, you know, I started making the soaps because he gets boils. And yeah, so I did pick up some of the pumice powder because my son and one of Matt's friends really likes a textured soap, so I got that. Hopefully it doesn't feel too much like sandpaper, like the apricot seeds or the ground ones. And then I picked up the rose clay because it's suitable for dry skin. Improving skin circulation, restores and replenishes skin with moisture and draws out impurities and lightly exfoliates. So I thought that might help. And then the arrowroot stimulates immune cells and boosts immune system. I don't know if that was actually like for if you consume it. But then for the soap, it says it may treat burns and sunburns, as well as drying up many blemishes and rashes. Also makes the skin feel soft and silky and smooths out the skin. Also helps keep the skin hydrated. And I thought that would be really good for, like, in the summertime, he goes fishing and they go on the boat and he always comes back burnt, like super red burnt. So I thought, you know, that would be a really good summertime soap. And then the fragrances I bought. Now I got this one because I was thinking it was gonna smell like my grandfather's pipe tobacco. Like, I loved when he would smoke his pipe. And I would always get him like cherry and vanilla scented or flavored so I could smell it when he smoked. So I bought this one. It's called Santa's Pipe. And it's the description is a cozy scent with notes of cherry wood, raspberry, vanilla, and tobacco. Now, I definitely get the cherry and it smells more like a cherry lollipop to me. It is really sweet. I get no tobacco out of this. None. It just smells like a cherry sweet lollipop to me. So I wish I had gotten just like a tobacco scent to throw it in there. I mean, it smells really nice and it might change once I add it to the soap batter. You know, it might draw out the tobacco smell, but we'll see. And then I picked up an almond, just a plain almond fragrance because Cameo contacted me and said she wanted a soap in a certain design. She sent a picture of the design and the colors and whatnot, and she wanted it scented in raspberry almond. Well, they don't make raspberry almond. They make raspberry and they make almond and they make almond cherry and all that, but they don't make an almond raspberry. So I got this and it's really nice. It's just like a warm, classic nutty almond is what it's called. I smell sweetness in it though too. So yeah. And it also could be because I'm getting everything on my hand. So let me go get a wipey. And then this next one I was skeptical about because it had patchouli in it, but as I bought many fragrances with patchouli in it, and I know it doesn't smell like what I associate, like the hippie dirty smell where it's just over empowering. So I bought it and it's called Black Rose and Spice. It is a sensual note of black rose, patchouli, orange zest, vanilla, orchid, and cinnamon leaf. I have no idea what black rose smells like, but this is really nice. And out of all of these, this was Matt's favorite. And I'm telling you, he is not a hippie person. I do get the orange and the cinnamon, and it's really a spicy scent. Definitely, you get a spice. And if I was better at this, I could definitely pick out other scents, but yeah. So I think I'm gonna try doing this for him. Like I said, I have a really hard time finding male scents that are manly, honestly. Or if I get a male scent, it usually doesn't hold. And then because Christmas is coming, I picked up some orange cranberry. It says freshly squeezed oranges kissed with the tart cranberry. A crisp blend is sure to awaken the senses. I'm honestly not even excited about this whatsoever. To me, I want to kind of say like the smell of what, or the taste of what a pacifier smells, tastes like. If you turned it into a, yeah, I just don't like it. I mean, maybe it'll change in the batter, but I'm very disappointed in that one. And then the sweater weather. I'm so excited about this. It says whispers of calming wind. Who knows what calming wind smells like besides, I mean, depends on where you live. It's complemented with tantalizing citron zest, sheer nuisance of cyclamen flower. Never heard of it. Have no idea. Joined with warm amber and trailing ivy, undertones of sandalwood, midnight jasmine, and oak moss. I thought this was gonna be like really manly. I was so excited. It smells. I don't know. I really don't know on this one. It's very light. I'm glad I got the big bottle. And it compares to Bath and Body Works. Whatever their scent is, but. So if you smelt that, it's probably exactly. I mean, these guys do really good on getting close to the scents. But it's very light. And then I picked up. Oh. Brown sugar. This is a decadent sweet brown sugar with vanilla. And it definitely smells like a bag of brown sugar when you open it up. And I just got this to add to other fragrances. If I don't like it, like per se, and I think it needed a little sweetness, I will add that to it. Where's the one? Oh. This one is my absolute favorite. Caramel Butterscotch Bourbon. Rich butterscotch, soft caramel. God, I'm having a hard time. And warm sugar. There is actually no scent description. When in this scent description, it does not say anything about bourbon. But bourbon's and one of my favorite scents, actually. I would have never thought. It's got. You can definitely smell the butterscotch and the caramel. And then it's got like this woodsy or burnt wood smell in it, which I really, really like. This is just so delicious. I mean, if I was to make like some caramel, homemade caramel, and added like a smoke scent to it, that is what I would call this. So it's just wonderful. I've never tasted bourbon, but bourbon smells really good in the scents that I've gotten before. So let me know which is your favorite and if you even enjoy this, because I know most of you are crafty people now. But yeah, I would love to be able to make soap videos again, but my camera doesn't allow me that much time anymore. So I don't know. Probably time for a new camera, but I'm not thinking about it because this is still working. So But that's it. And I will talk to you later. Bye.